Welcome to this tutorial on how to use WordPress 2022. In just 15 minutes, we are going to see how to build a complete and online website from zero, even if this is your first time. WordPress is an open-source content management system, or CMS, based on PHP language, used to build and launch websites online quickly and easily. Through its user interface, you can modify your website content and appearance without coding, since it acts on your website HTML and CSS files on the background. It also helps you keeping your website updated and safe. To start with a new website, you need a hosting server and proper domain. If you have these already and you just want to know how to use WordPress, please skip to our WordPress Dashboard chapter. To run the website online, you may need a hosting server, or host. This is the physical computer that stores all our website files to make them available online. The server is only accessible through complex IP addresses, reason why a proper domain must be associated. The domain is the alphanumeric name, such as theskillsfactory.com, that is easier to type. Remember, search on browser or rank on Google rather than IP addresses. Once the domain is associated to your hosting IP address, your website is online and ready to get discovered with the proper name. To get host and domain, you just have to type hosting on Google and find any plan that includes both of these, especially if you're a beginner. Separate plans are possible, but you may need knowledge on DNS records. Please check our video description and get suggested links for hosts and domains. Once you have host and domain, you only need to install WordPress on your server. This is indeed a piece of software run on your host in order to load the user interface that you will use to edit your website. To do so, you have two options, WordPress.com and WordPress.org. WordPress.com offers a paid hosting service with up-to-date security updates, but with several limitations on website editing and plugins as a free plan. So we suggest to go for WordPress.org, which is complete and totally free, despite it requires a proper installation in your host. Most of the hosting servers already include a quick option to install WordPress. For example, if you get a hosting plan with Hostgator, you just have to log in with the username, password, and link given to enter into its main control panel, or CP panel, and then find WordPress in the list. The process is fully guided. Enter the website domain, specify the homepage directory, which also collects all WordPress files, set administrator username and password for WordPress, and click on Install. You can also install WordPress manually with its archive in your host or in your local computer. Please check out our video description to learn more. When the installation ends, you will get two links. The first one leads to your website homepage, which is already online with the default WordPress template. The second one, made by your domain, your directory, and WP admin, leads to the login page for your admin account just created. Once you log in, you enter into the main WordPress dashboard, complete with all the options to manage and edit your website. The first time, you may go to Updates to run any WordPress update to keep your website safe and secure. To get a quick preview, go to My Blog, visit Site. You can keep this tab open on your browser to refresh it and check your modifications live. Now let's see how to change the website theme. This fixes the general website appearance and layout, including the placement of several elements. Go to Appearance, Themes, and browse for the right theme among the ones installed, applying any with Activate. You can also go to Add New Theme to search and install other themes, complete with user reviews. Only once they are installed, they can be applied to your website. To edit the current theme, go to Appearance, Customize. On the left, you get several options for your theme with a live update on the website. Pay attention that these options may be limited in case you use any free theme version. With Site Identity, you can add a proper title and description on top, making them live with Publish above. You can also import a proper logo from your WordPress media library. At first, this is empty, so you may need to upload such file from your computer. Make sure to remove title and description if the logo includes these. On Site Icon, you can select any image to use as favicon, which is the small logo appearing on the browser tab. Below Site Identity, go to Colors to choose the main colors for each site element, applying with Publish above. Whereas with Background Image, you can apply any image to the whole site background, adjusting size, position, or repeating it until you fill the background completely. On Blog Post Settings, you can hide or show any post information or even the complete sidebar on the right. Some of these options may be available or not, depending on the chosen theme. In this case, there is a possibility to add header contacts on top, or social icons on the footer at the bottom. You can also manage menus and widgets that are going to be seen in a while. Switch to Homepage Settings to show your latest posts or any specific page as homepage. Now let's see how to write your first post. Click on Post on the left to get the list of all your posts. By default, you only have one called Hello World, but you can go to Add New to start writing another with the block editor. This allows you to build your post by composing several independent blocks together, each adding text, media files, or pieces of HTML code. First of all, define a proper title, the first line of your body text, or simply copy-paste any content you have ready. Each text paragraph is indeed an independent block with its own properties. Moreover, use the Enter key to start with a new line and either type a new paragraph block or use the plus button on the right to search for a specific block. Choose Heading to add any title by following the H tag, bigger in size and bold in style. With Quote, you can type any quoted text. Click on Image to import any image by uploading any file from your computer, from the media library, or with any URL. Whereas add a YouTube block to embed any video by providing its URL, or a list block to make bulleted or numbered lists. Check our links in the video description to learn more about all the blocks of WordPress Block Editor. In the top left corner, you can switch to Select Mode to select any block without interacting with its content, and return to Edit Mode to modify each block in detail. Use the Undo and Redo buttons to undo, redo actions made, and open the list view to check out all the blocks composing your post. To edit any block, select it and use either its dialog box or the block panel on the right. When dealing with text blocks, you can change style, alignment, and text color. You can also set the font size and select any piece of text to apply modifications only where it's needed. You may not be able to change the font family since this is fixed by the main theme. You can also select any text and click on the link button to add a hyperlink with a proper URL. When selecting images, you can add links or use the crop tool to zoom in and out, change its aspect ratio, or rotate it. With Replace, change the image and switch to the block section to manage corners. Add any alt text in case the image does not load correctly, or modify the image size. You can also set alignment add captions, or apply duotone filters. Moreover, click on the three dots to copy any block, duplicate it, or insert a new block before or after it. Go to Remove Block to delete it, and use Edit as HTML to edit its source code in HTML language. Coming back with Edit Visually. You can also click and drag from the second button to move each block up or down in the list. From the Post section, you can set the visibility for each post, its release date, the current one or any scheduled one, and its custom URL called permalink. Under Featured Image, upload any image to present the post. In the top right corner, save your article and click on Publish to make it live online in your homepage. Always check its appearance on desktops, tablets, and smartphones. The saved article appears in the posts list, with options to edit it again. Manage its properties with Quick Edit, or delete it with Trash. When you start getting lots of posts, you may create categories to group these together. At first, all posts belong to the default uncategorized category. Go to Categories on the left to create a new one with proper name and custom URL or slug. You can also make categories within any main or parent category. At this point, you can assign any post to specific categories directly with Quick Edit. Each category URL shows all the posts matching such category, each with its featured image applied. Click on Pages to create static pages. In respect to posts, these do not have any author or publication date. You can create and build pages with the same block editor, but you still need to share the page URL somewhere, through any hyperlink or menu, or it won't be accessible. For example, let's make a menu by going to Appearance, Menus. Set any name, click on Create Menu, and then add its items, such as custom URL links, your site pages, or any category. You can also adjust their order or make these dependent. Once done, go to Save Menu and check the result online. Go to Plugins to manage all your third-party applications and extend your WordPress features. You can also go to Add New to browse for others, such as the Classic Editor plugin. Once this is installed, click on Activate to turn it on and come back to the older editor. To learn more about the Classic Editor, make sure to check out our dedicated chapter of our previous WordPress 2021 tutorial. You may also include widgets, such as additional elements added on your site to improve the user experience. For example, the lateral sidebar or the custom footer at the bottom. Check these out. On the left side, you get further options to manage the comments left in your website, your registered users, or the basic website properties under Settings. Here, change the website title, its main description, or tagline, or its URL links as they should appear within the searches. Also manage the admin addresses, the data format, and other options. To respect privacy regulations, you may need to set a privacy policy page as well. You can build a good one with the free privacypolicygenerator.info website. Just insert your company name, your website name, and its URL. Then reply to all questions. And finally, copy the entire HTML code resulted. At this point, create a new page. Paste the code directly with the Control or Command and V and publish it. Make sure to include this page to your menu, or it won't be accessible. Thank you very much for watching this tutorial. Make sure to visit our channel and subscribe for more free and amazing content.